Thomas Frank recently made a video where he broke down the top ways that people don't use Notion correctly. And in my opinion, there are a lot of good ones that he put in there, but I actually have 5 different mistakes that people make when they use Notion on a daily basis. The first big mistake people make when using Notion, in my opinion, is that they don't use linked databases for every view. So in the Evergreen Notion workspace, I actually have all of my databases hidden back here. And instead of having any of these ever be the main source of what I'm viewing, I just have it on the back end. Because what happens is if I were to duplicate a database like this, none of these different views would showcase. But if I instead go into one of my different pages, you can see if I take this and duplicated it, all of the exact same views would showcase. And if all I needed to do was change filtering and keep the same views, then I'd have the exact same stuff. But if you don't do that, then what you end up having to deal with is if in the first place you took your different views for your tasks and then you duplicate it, then what happens is, oh, that just makes a new database. Also, if you copy from a view and make a linked database, you can see it doesn't have the exact same views. And that's what happened if you'd copy and make a linked database from your main view. So always start out by making a linked database from your original view and then duplicating from there. So the second big mistake that a lot of people make is that they don't have mobile specific views. So as you can see on my phone right now and on the screen, if I interact with something like this, it's a lot more functional than the main workspace. So as you can see here, I have a nice toggle block set up where I can go through all the main things that matter to me in a very condensed and easy to use format rather than if I had the main page. Because if I go to the top left here, the interactions that I have, if I go to my actions page, this is a lot worse, but it looks a lot better on the desktop view. As you can see, this looks fine on the desktop view, but it doesn't look great on the view of the mobile app. So that's why all I needed to do was make some linked databases and make mobile specific pages with a synced header that's used for itself rather than trying to use desktop pages for a mobile view. And that brings us to the next mistake, not using the synced header views that you can have. So if you toggle this, this takes off a significant portion of the screen and in my opinion does not have the best sort of functionality. So if I do this drop down here, looking at all this and trying to navigate through all this is a lot harder than just navigating through this. And if I untick this, I get more screen real estate, I'm focused on what I'm doing, and then all I need to do is do a quick scroll up, and I can interact with pretty much anything via doing this. I have had a lot of different setups in Notion, and anytime I've used a synced block as a header, it's a lot better. All you need to do to make any of these things happen is take a share and copy link, or press the 3 dots and press copy link, and then just put an emoji like a pad here, and then all I need to do is paste it over as like an H2 or something. Or as you can see here, what you can also do is you could take that link, paste it, and do a mention, and then it gives you this sort of view. Now, another big mistake people do in Notion is that they actually don't segment things by relations rather than tags. So if you use something like a select or a multi-select property, it's nice to showcase here that this is what it is. However, filtering regarding relations is a better sort of segmentation, because what will happen is you can have interconnectivity between something and you can use formulas that connect to it. So for example, in my second brain, when I connect something to a content idea and I connect it to a content calendar, rather than putting it as this type just as content idea, I can have different statuses from formulas that showcase whether these two things are related, and then I can easily filter it out automatically. And then when I go into this different thing, if I were to have taken notes on the previous one, I could go back into this idea in Notion, whereas if I just was using a select property to segment it out, I wouldn't be able to maybe get some ideas. If I had put some quick capture thought ideas when I made this, I wouldn't be able to navigate between those two so easily. But since they're related, rather than having it be a select or multi-select property that just said it was a content idea, this is just a much better route to go. And then to me, the last big mistake that people make is they don't use nested columns. So what is a nested column? It's a column within a column. So if we look here, you can see this is broken up in three different columns. 1, 2, 3. However, right here, I seem to have another set of columns within this. So the sizing of this should be bigger than the sizing of these because these are static. These are going to be the exact things that I'm going to be doing for my habit tracking. And these never get larger than this. And I don't need to see any relations knowing what branches of my life it's a part of. So these don't need to be as large. So if I had just taken this and not done the nested column, I'd have a bunch of wasted space here. But since I did a nested column, which I have a video on that if you want to go check that out, I can condense the amount of information into a closer space and not waste as much space on the application.
If you like this video, make sure to check out this one to see how you can improve your Notion even more.